Hello everyone, this is going to be my first attempt to look at using arc and mutex in Rust. So let's just demonstrate what I've written, and it's based on a couple of tutorials which I'll discuss in due course. So if we just run the code, it's actually using threads. So if we run it again, you can see it's non-deterministic. So I've got red, okay. NeoVim's showing me the colors. It's incrementing a counter 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the counter is being incremented each time, but a different thread is doing the operation. And how do the threads know what the previous value was? And it's getting locked. So it gets locked by the mutex, which, so I thought by using colors, this would. I know one of my recent videos where I used the progress bars was quite popular, and I just think trying to visualize this is much more instantly kind of understandable than doing lots of numbers and whatever. So, yeah, red, green, blue, and then we had red, magenta, green. So the different threads, if we run it again, in the state, it's non-deterministic. So that's kind of the key thing to remember, because the threads or the processes, as I understand it, are managed by the kernel. So, yeah, please don't have a go at me in the comments, because I'm trying to learn this, and I just wanted to share this in case it's of value to anyone else. So we just exit this and let's go and actually look at the code. CD source MV main. Okay, so use standard sync, and then we're using arc and we're using mutex. So whatever example you do, let me just quickly turn off the hints because they just make it look scary, don't they? So whatever you do, even once you when you kind of start learning this on kind of day one, you'll have to use standard sync and then arc and mutex. So what it's doing is it's creating a shared counter wrapped in an arc and a mutex. That stands for arc is atomic reference count. Right. So counter, the number that we're starting with, the counter is one. And then we put that inside a mutex. Then we put an atomic reference counter around that. Create a vector to hold the thread handles. So we're going to create multiple thread handles, and they get created here as we do the thread spawn. And then we say let mutable num equal counter lock unwrap. So don't worry about all the colorization, that's just really to make it easy to understand. Down here, we then take the handles and we push each handle that we've created. So each time we spawn a thread, let the handle equal thread spawn. So every time we iterate between 0 up to 5, it's creating a new handle. The handle then gets added to the vector, which is this vector here. And then ultimately we've got a vector of handles, and then we iterate through the for each hand for every handle in the handles vector. We then do the handle join. We need to do this because we need to wait for all the threads to finish. Otherwise, if main finished before the threads had finished, we wouldn't get all of the threads finishing and completing. So then print the final value of the counter, and this is where we need to use lock. So lock, it's kind of, I don't know, counterintuitive really, but counter dot, it means kind of, it's more like the key rather than lock, I would have said. Take over the key and unwrap it. Yeah, keys, locks, whatever. And then we, because the final value is a reference, we need to access the final value. That's why we use the deref, we're dereferencing it. So the final value is actually comes from the counter. And again, counter up here, and this because it's a arc clone of a reference, then we turn this back on. I'll just turn back on arc mutex i32. So that's why we down here, that's as I understand it, that's why we need to then use this, because the value is actually inside the mutex, which is inside the arc, and it's actually a reference. So we need to get to this value. So on this line, which is line 14, it's a reference, which means that when we ultimately want to actually get to it down here, we need to get the value out of the reference. This don't worry about too much, because it's just me doing pretty stuff with the colors. What I'll do is put the gist of this in the description of the video, and then if you want to edit it, mess around with it, break it, as usual, I think that's probably, there's some value in doing that. So handles, you'll do that as soon as you start looking at threads. That's not particular to Arc and Mutex, but the atomic reference count, so this is new. And then what this is doing is it's cloning the counter and keeping a tally of how many times it's cloned the counter. This is the lock the mutex to access the shared counter. So each time it's effectively saying, I'm having it now. Nobody else can modify it until I've finished with it. That's how I understand it. And don't treat this as a tutorial, but just treat it as watching somebody experiment, and just hopefully this has given you an idea for how you might want to go about trying to learn it. So this channel's called Learning Rust. It's not expert Rust or official Rust, or this is how a mere mortal goes about learning Rust. So as you can see, again, I ran it there, and it's non-deterministic, and you'll see non-deterministic written quite often. And basically what that means is you get a different result. You may or may not get a different result each time you run it. So yeah, red, green, yellow, red, blue, green. So I'll put this code in the gist in the description, and feel free to experiment with it. And if you can think of a better way to kind of visualize it, I'd be interested. I tried progress bars, but I think kind of just doing it with the colors, a different color for each thread is probably quite nice. Just run it again for lols. There we go. Red, green, red, magenta, green, red, green, yellow. So this is basically, it's colorizing the, let's just go and review the colors one last time. So depending on the number of the thread, so thread one will be green, thread two will be yellow, so on. You get the idea. So the thread numbers are represented as colors. So typically red will quite often be the first one, but then the second one could be two, that's thread two, there it's not, so it changes. Thanks for watching. And let me know if this is interesting or if it's a good way of showing it. And please feel free to add comments about Arc and Mutex, because, again, the channel's called Learning Rust. I'm trying to learn Arc and Mutex. Self-taught. I don't want to just use ChatGPT. I have got the book, which is called, not the book, but a book called Rust Crash Course by Abhishek Kumar. If you've got any good recommendations for kind of a second book, Rust for Rustations, I think, is probably slightly beyond my level at the moment, but if you can recommend kind of a good second book, I'd be interested. And The Rust in Action by Tim Clicks, I'm starting to read as well. But there's a lot of systems programming stuff in there and stuff about some good stuff in there about Endianness. If you've not come across Endianness, little Endian and big Endian, then that's good. That kind of that's good because I've got a bit of an interest in Bitcoin, and that is very relevant to how the Bitcoin core code is written. Yeah, and then you've got nibbles, words, bytes, and there's it's basically probably like equivalent to computer science course. Not that I've ever done one, but if that's of interest, then Rust in Action by Tim Clicks. You can get some discount codes on that as well if you search around as well. Not from any dodgy places, but just from certain places if you have a look.